is about reading Surah Al-Ikhlas for a dead person. There's no prescription whatsoever in the Sunnah or in the companions' activities that the Prophet ﷺ instructed us to read any Quran for any person, whether related or not related, especially, I mean, the dead. Rather, we have been instructed to make dua for them. Salatul Janazah, the funeral prayer, is all about dua. We don't have ruku' and sujood. We don't recite Quran other than Al-Fatiha, but we make dua for the dead. It puzzles me, why do people abandon what Allah has approved and what He likes and what the Prophet ﷺ has commended, and they search for things which are not supported by sound reference? Why? Why some people insist on going to the grave and reciting Surah Yasin? Or reciting, making khatmah, gathering people to recite the whole Quran, say, oh Allah, give the thawab of this, the reward of this recitation to such and such. They say, some scholars say it works. Okay. But we have the actions of the Prophet ﷺ are very clear and very bright, like the daylight. Stick to that. So, there is no narration or evidence that says, because I have seen that once on the graveyard, somebody said we need to recite Surah Al-Ikhlas 10 times and Surah this, how many times? This is all innovation. Dua, and that's it. You want to benefit your beloved person? Whether it's a child or a parent or a spouse, a brother or a sister, related, not related, a friend you like, then make dua for them. Just include them in your dua. You read whatever Quran, as much Quran as you want. And after you finish, make dua for them. Because the dua after ibadah is most likely to be accepted. Make dua for them in your sujood, in the prayer. If these guys did not perform Umrah or Hajj and you have an access to perform Umrah on their behalf, do it. May Allah bless you for that. But you cannot offer the prayer on their behalf. You can make up the fasting if they missed any and they owe it and they died before making it up. You can make it up in their state. But the prayers and reading the Quran, it is best to keep that. It's not best for the prayers. You cannot pray on behalf of any other person. You cannot pray on behalf of any other person, even the closest person to you. As far as the Quran, I feel very comfortable to read Quran for my own self, hoping that I will collect the reward of my own recitation. Then when I finish, I remember my beloved ones and I make dua for them. After I finish the Quran, I sit and I make dua. I gather my family members and I pray for myself. I pray for my deceased family members, my grandparents, my beloved ones. This is the way it should be. Not to sit and give the reward of the recitation to somebody because that was not prescribed by the Prophet ﷺ, even though some scholars said it does benefit. I like to stick to what's guaranteed.